Hey, Kendall, you're fine. You're just not as sharp. You just get there like just like a hair late. Do you notice that?
I love Abby. She's my music manager. But it's not like she owns me. I'm not like her product. I'm a person. I'm a human.
Okay, listen to me. This is the first competition of the season. While you're off doing the singing and the acting and the movie and this and that and everything, everybody else is grabbing their leg and pulling it over their head. And those are the people that are gonna end up beating you in the long run. The dancing has to come first, and that's what you all seem to be forgetting.
I can speak for my child. She doesn't want to be a competition dancer the rest of her life. She wants to sing and dance and act. I've put my trust and all of my faith in Abby. I just need to know what her plans are. I want what's best for you.
Well, you're not
doing
much.
I had to stand in there and listen to Abby.
Then wait. Let's go.
Okay.
What's wrong?
She wants you to manage her. She wants all this.
She needs to work harder, Joe. She was in ballet class last night. She was a mess. She was a hot mess.
Let's go, Kendall. I'm not putting up with it. Come on. Let's go. If you think she's a hot mess and you can't manage her, then someone else
will. I want her to be better.
And no other kid was a hot mess.
But they were all were.
Okay.
Some of them didn't
could
even take
go,
it.
Could you tell their parents in front of their kid that their kids were hot messes?
Every single one of them was a hot mess.
Why do you always pick on mine?
You asked me. You're starting this.
I did not ask you, was my kid a hot mess in ballet? I have
Kendall,
to go.
Kendall,
I cannot.
What is wrong with you,
I'm
honey?
Just done with this. I'm done.
Kendall. Kendall. Kendall, stop.
I'm not gonna do this.
Okay, we can leave.
Let's go.
Okay. You hold your head high in there. That fight between Abby and I, that's between us. It's an argument.
I just wanted to say you could have done it in private, not in front of
us. I understand that, but she starts it, and I'm not gonna let her walk all over us. And I'm sorry if I upset you. That's the last thing in the world I would ever do.
You did.
Well, I will try hard not to, but I need you to go in there and be the Kendall that everybody knows and loves, okay?
Okay.
All right, let's go. I know Kendall doesn't like to see me argue with Abby, but it's heartbreaking for me to sit back and watch Kendall get passed by for Brynn. Kendall has worked too hard to be Abby's number two, and I can't let that go to waste.
So, sit down here with me. Okay, that whole thing that happened yesterday, that was not me yelling at you. That was your mother screaming about something and then you getting upset. I look at you and think that you don't work hard enough. And I think your mother looks at you and looks at the hour you wake up and the hour you go to sleep and sees what you're doing and thinks, oh my God, this kid is working so hard. But I'm not seeing it. You gotta figure it out.
I'm angry that she brought that up like that was my fault. That was not my fault. But I don't want to upset Kendall. And then, you know, she's mad at me, so she goes straight to Kendall.
She knows how to get to you.
And if she only knew everything we could have been doing all summer, and I didn't. Out of loyalty to her. But now I've got to think, well, wait a minute. You know, everybody's gonna pass me up and pass me by. Sometimes you gotta take chances.
So are you saying at this point, you, if an opportunity presents itself, whether it's with Abby or without Abby, if it's right for Kendall, you're gonna take advantage of it?
If it's a great opportunity that can catapult her, absolutely. I need to focus on Kendall's future. And if it means doing things without Abby, so be it.